मॉर्निंग मिस।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मिस।
गुड मॉर्निंग मिस।
गुड मॉर्निंग मिस।
गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। ओके नाउ यू कैन टाइप योर अटेंडेंस। Please type attendance in your chat box.
Miss Chedu.
Okay. Okay. Today we are going to take grammar session. Okay. You have grammar session in page number 110. All of you take page number 110.
Is grammar practice or not?
Yes, grammar practice.
Listen, na njan onnu pen eduthu.
Make it fast. Take your notebook and pen. Okay.
Page number
110. Don't forget to type attendance. Then, shall we start? Please turn on your videos.
Yes.
Turn on your videos. Okay. First, we are going to study about sentences. Can you define sentences? Anybody?
Miss, can I?
Okay.
Group of words are
together express an idea.
Group of meaningful words are called a sentence.
Okay. Once more, please repeat once more. Joanna.
A group of words which together express an idea is called sentence.
Okay, very good. Then Sri Vishnu, you can also express.
The group of words join make a meaning is called sentences.
Yes, group of words that make a complete sense. It is called a sentence. In a sentence, you can see group of words, isn't it? Yes. Now, did you know how many types of sentences are there?
Miss?
Present, past, future.
No, that is tenses.
Miss?
Okay, who's that? Aradhya, okay.
Eight number?
Page number 110. 110.
Declarative sentence.
Yes, declarative sentence. There are four types of sentences. First one is declarative or assertive sentence. Then?
Interrogative sentence.
Interrogative sentence.
Imperative sentence.
Imperative sentence. And? Exclamatory sentence. These are the four types of sentences. Okay. Now we can move to the textbook. Listen carefully. A group of words that make a complete sense is called a sentence. I think it's clear. A group of words that make a complete sense. We will get a meaning from that sentence. That is called a sentence. A group of words that make a complete sense. Sometimes we group a group of words makes sense but not complete sense. Such a group of words is called a phrase. Yes, in certain cases, some group of words make a sense but not a complete sense. We will get a sense but not a complete sense from that group of words. That type of sentences are called phrase.
Phrase.
Yes. You can see an example. After the ceremony, the scenic valley. After the ceremony. This is a sentence, isn't it? This is a group of words, isn't it? We will get a sense from that, isn't it? But not a complete sense. After the ceremony. After the ceremony, we will get a sense from that, but not a complete sense from these group of words. These type of words are called phrases. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes. Then one more example is there. The scenic valley. The scenic valley. We can change phrases into sentence by adding words to them. Yes. If we make a sentence, we will get a complete sense, isn't it? So, we can change a phrase. We can change phrase into sentences. What we can do? We can change phrase into
sentences.
Yes, sentences. For example, after the ceremony, I will speak to Saif. After the ceremony. It's a complete sentence, isn't it? After yes. The ceremony, I will speak to Saif. We get a complete sense, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. That's the difference between phrase and sentence. Phrase, in phrase, we will not get a complete sense. In sentence, we will get a complete sense. Then we are moving to the four kinds of sentences. Listen carefully. Four types of sentences. First one, declarative or assertive sentences. Declarative or assertive sentences. You can see the definition. State or declare something. Yes. Declarative or assertive sentence. Declarative sentence is also known as assertive sentence. In this sentence, we can see a statement. State or declare something. In declarative sentence, we declare or state something. Is it clear? These sentences ends with a full stop. We know that sentences begin with capital letter and ends with the full stop. Then only full stop. Sometimes
question mark.
Yes, sometimes question mark. Then sometimes
exclamatory symbol.
Yes, exclamatory mark. Okay. Here, in the case of declarative sentence. The case of declarative sentence, it is in the form of a statement. Begins with the sentence begins with the capital letter and ends with a full stop. Is it clear? Sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop in the case of declarative or assertive
sentences.
Yes. For example, you can see an example. Arunima Sinha is the first female amputee to climb the Mount Everest. To climb the Mount Everest. This is a statement, isn't it? This is a statement. You can see that the statement begins with a capital letter and ends with a
full stop.
Yes, ends with the full stop. So that we can say that declarative or assertive sentence means a statement or to declare something. Okay, is it clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, any doubt? It's very important. No. No doubt. Okay, then shall we move to the next type of sentence, which is the second one?
Interrogative sentences.
Yes. Interrogative sentences ask questions. Interrogative questions. Okay. Then what will be the structure? The sentence begins with a
capital letter
and ends with a question
mark. Ends with a question mark.
Yes. The sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with the question marks. Can you give an example for an interrogative sentence?
What is your name?
Yes, what is your name? Very good. Then one more example.
How old are you?
How old are you?
Where is your house?
What are you doing?
Yes, what are you doing?
Where are you from? Come.
Yes, where are you coming from? Okay.
What is your job?
Yes.
What is your father's name?
Yes. Very good. I think you got an idea about interrogative sentence, isn't it?
Yes, miss.
Yes. Here you can.
Yes,
here you can see an example. When was Mangalyaan launched by ISRO? That's a question. Begins with a capital letter and ends with a question mark. Okay. Okay. Juvana, what happened?
Yes, when you asked this question, I was about to answer that one.
I can't hear.
Yes, when you asked this question, I was about to answer.
Oh. Okay. Then third one, imperative sentences. Imperative sentences. Imperative sentences express a command, make a request, or a suggestion. Imperative sentence, we can say that command, then request and suggestion. These include in imperative sentences. Keep quiet. A command. Please lend me this book. Request. Consider taking an umbrella. These type of command or request or a suggestion. These type of sentences are coming under imperative sentences. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Can you give some examples for imperative sentences?
He said to close the door.
To complete my homework.
Okay.
Close the door.
Close the door, okay. Any other?
Shut up,
okay.
Please keep your.
You should do your work.
Command, okay. Okay.
Please on your video.
Okay.
Would you please take that umbrella?
Wear mask.
Okay. I think it's clear for you, isn't it? Imperative sentences are commands, requests, or suggestion. Then last one, exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentence. Express strong or sudden feelings or emotions. Exclamatory sentence express strong or sudden feelings or emotions. They end with an exclamation mark. Begins with a capital letter and ends with an exclamation mark. We can use what, such, what a, Watan or Sachan to make exclamatory sentences. Okay. Is it clear? Can you give an example for exclamatory sentence?
What an ouch.
Oh my God.
What a surprise.
Yes, what a surprise. Okay, good. How pretty?
What a workout.
Which one?
What a work.
What a work. Okay.
Wow, this is a pleasant surprise.
Okay.
What a lovely picture.
Yes, okay, good. Okay, I think you got an idea about four types of sentences. Isn't it?
Yes.
Halima, can you name the four types of sentences? Which are the four types of sentences? Four types of sentences. I will ask. Okay. Halima, you don't know? Now we are discussing about four types of sentences. In page number 110, you can see. Then, Aromal, can you say which are the four types of sentences? Four types of sentences. You don't know? Okay, I will call you. Please wait, please wait. Jeeva.
Declarative sentences, interrogative sentences, imperative sentences, exclamatory sentences.
Yes, very good. These are the four types of sentences. Aromal and Halima. Is it clear? Four types of sentences are declarative sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, and exclamatory sentence. Okay? These are the four types of sentences. Then, Adira. Can you give an example for a declarative sentence? Declarative sentence.
Declarative sentence.
Example.
Eduthu parayan pattum miss.
Endana?
Ivide example koduthathu parayan pattu nu.
You can say another example. A statement. Declarative sentence is a statement, isn't it? So you can say a statement.
Okay. Adira is coming from Perumbadal.
Yes. Yes. Very good. Then, Juana, can you give an example for interrogative sentence?
Where are you coming from?
Yes, where are you coming from? Then, Justice, can you give an example for imperative sentence?
Shut up your mouth.
Yes. then Harinand, can you give an example for exclamatory sentence?
What is a beautiful place is this?
What a beautiful place. Okay. Then Payal, can you give an example for declarative sentence? Declarative sentence. Declarative sentence means a statement. To state or declare something. Okay. Then Aradhya, can you say an example for declarative sentence?
What is her name?
Declarative sentence. Declarative. What is your name is an example for interrogative sentence. Declarative. Declarative or assertive? Okay. Who will say an example? Who is ready to say an example? Okay, Sri Vishnu, you can say.
This is our headboard.
Yes, very good. Then.
Siamardana.
Okay.
Sun rise up in the east and the west.
Okay, very good. Then anyone is ready to answer? Delvin?
Yes, please.
Okay. Say an example for declarative sentence.
Grandma is going to participate in the Olympic Games this year.
Okay. Then okay, I think it's enough. You got an idea about types of sentence, four types of sentence, isn't it? Arjun?
Please.
Can you say an example for imperative sentence? Imperative sentence. Imperative sentence means? Ask a question. Ask
no.
A question. No.
That is interrogative.
I mean, yes,
ask questions.
Yes. Ask questions. Interrogative. Yes. Interrogative.
Imperative.
Where are you going?
Where are you going? Interrogative example. Okay. Then you want to complete an activity. A. Turn to page 6, find an example each of an exclamatory sentence and a declarative sentence. Write them in your notebook. Turn to page 6. Page 6. Take page 6. Then find out an example for exclamatory sentence.
Can I tell?
Okay.
Let's find out.
Yes, I also find out it.
Okay, you can say.
There, isn't this lovely?
Exclamatory sentence.
Miss Nyamarada.
Okay.
What a pretty street.
Yes, very good. What a pretty street. example for exclamatory sentence. You can write it in your notebook.
Miss.
Then declarative sentence. Then you should find a declarative sentence also from that page, page number 6.
Miss, front page la ni edandathu.
You can write it in your back side. Okay, grammar portions. Okay.
She stopped with a little choking breath.
Yes, very good. She stopped with a little choking breath. You can write there example for exclamatory sentence. Then write it as a heading, example for exclamatory sentence.
Note.
Yes. Back side.
Try to keep up with her.
Example for exclamatory sentence. Angane ezhuthuka ennittu adinte example kudi ezhuthi vekkuka. What a pretty street. What a pretty street.
Notebook in the back side.
Yes. Did you write? Okay. Example for exclamatory sentence.
Miss, declarative. Let's revise le oru chodyam edam.
You should find it from page number 6.
Aa oru page il mathrame vettullu.
Yes. She stopped with a little choking breath. She stopped with a little choking breath is the example for declarative sentence. Did you write?
Sonamodim parayo.
First endha cheyandanu vachala exclamatory sentence. Example for exclamatory sentence nezhuthuka. And shesham what a pretty street. Example. Okay. Then example for declarative sentence, that is, you can see she stopped with a little choking breath. Page number 6. In page number 6, you can see she stopped with a little choking breath. Did you see?
Is adu mathrame ezhuthiya mathiyo?
Yes. Find an example. That means one example, okay? Then did you complete?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Then B, turn to page 3. Find an example of an imperative sentence. Write it in your notebook. Turn to page 3. Page 3. Example for imperative sentence.
The window must have been raised at some time.
Imperative sentence. Suggestion, command, or request.
I deserve you to meet her at the station.
Yes, very good. I desire you to meet her at the station. I desire you to meet her at the station. Did you see page number 3, first paragraph in this side? Okay.
അവസാന സെന്റൻസ് അല്ലേ ആ പാരഗ്രാഫില്.
Yes, I desire you to meet her at the station. Example for imperative sentence. Is it clear? Yes. Then
അത് കമാൻഡ് അല്ലേ മിസ്?
ഐ ഡിസയർ യു ടു മീറ്റ് ഹർ അറ്റ് ദ സ്റ്റേഷൻ കമാൻഡ് ആണോ?
റിക്വസ്റ്റ് ആണ്.
ഒരു സജഷൻ
അല്ലേ? സജഷൻ യെസ്. ഓക്കേ, ദൻ ടേൺ ടു പേജ് 4, ഫൈൻഡ് ആൻ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഓഫ് ആൻ ഇൻട്രോഗേറ്റീവ് സെന്റൻസ്. പേജ് 4. Page number 4.
Miss, in that one, can we take some let's revise in that page?
No. From your story.
Are you Miss Juliana?
Yes, very good. This is an example for interrogative. Are you Miss Juliana? Are you Miss Juliana? Did you see that?
Miss, have you answered?
Here. Are you Miss Juliana? Okay. Did you write it? Yes. Okay, once more we can say the answers. Okay, first one, find an example for exclamatory sentence. Who will say answer? Please read the answer you have written. Okay,
number 6, what a pretty street.
Yes. Okay, then declarative sentence.
She stopped with a little chop the tree.
Yes, very good. Then next one, find an example of an imperative sentence from page number 3.
Missioner, you need to meet her at the station.
Page number 3.
I desire you to meet her at the station.
Yes. Okay. Then next one, interrogative sentence. Example for
Juliana.
Are you Miss Juliana? Okay. Very good. Okay. Any doubt regarding this types of sentences?
Miss, രണ്ടാമത്തൊന്ന് പറയോ.
Example of an imperative sentence.
Yes.
Okay, page number 3, in page number 3, I desire you to meet her at the station. I desire you to meet her at the station. Okay, is it clear?
Clear me.
Okay, a few more minutes remaining, so we can repeat it once more. It's very important. We have discussed 4 types of sentences, isn't it? Which are the four?
Yes.
Which are the 4 types of sentences?
Declarative sentences, interrogative sentences, imperative sentences, exclamatory sentences.
Yes, four types of, these are four types of sentences. Then declarative sentence means
statement already declaring something. These sentences end with a full stop.
Yes. Then interrogative sentence.
Asking questions
and end with a question mark.
Yes. Ends with a question mark. Then imperative sentence.
Consists of command, request, and suggestion.
Command, request, or suggestion. Last one, exclamatory sentence. That is.
Are you Miss Poliana?
That is an example.
Express strong or sudden feeling or emotions. They end with an exclamatory mark.
Yes. Express strong.
Such a, and to make exclamatory sentence.
Okay, very good. Okay, shall we wind up?
Yes.
Any doubts?
No doubt, miss.
Okay, we can meet in next period.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Is statement in the samadhan alle fact?
Yes. Okay, see you in the next class. Bye.
Bye, miss.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye, miss.